You probably know that Asian carp are a threat to the Great Lakes. But there's more to the story than those jumping fish in Illinois. For the latest, we take you to northern Ohio.
The Ohio DNR is going out on a fishing trip on the Sandusky River in Fremont, Ohio, about 25 miles southeast of Toledo. They're training to fish for Asian carp. Yes, they're looking for Asian carp 30 miles from Lake Erie. Chances are, when you think of Asian carp, you picture this. Fish leaping out of rivers as motorboats pass by. But only one species of Asian carp jumps like that. And there are four species that threaten the Great Lakes. Grass carp, silver carp, big head carp, and black carp. Great Lakes Now contributor Andrew Reeves is also the author of Overrun: Dispatches from the Asian Carp Crisis. He explains how the grass carp was originally brought to Arkansas to help fish farmers with the problem of aquatic weeds.
Grass carp, true to their word, proved to be really good at cleaning aquatic weeds. But the problem that we encountered really was we know that they managed to escape in a number of different ways.
Like grass carp, silver and big head carp were brought in to clean up waterways.
It was later on with the introduction of silver and big head carp that eat like phyto and zooplankton, filter feeders that sort of swim through the water column. They're the ones that we tried to find a use for in catfish ponds, cleaning algae, and then later cleaning sewage lagoons.
Finally, there are black carp, which have molar-like teeth in their throats for crushing mollusk shells.
Black carp eat native freshwater mussels and clams especially. The big, big black carp will actually just swallow them, shells and all, and let their stomach acid basically take what they need.
Black carp have been found in low numbers in several states, especially along the Mississippi River. They could become a bigger threat in the future. All four of these fish species can grow large, up to 100 pounds. And they can eat anywhere from 20 to 120% of their body weight a day. If they get into the Great Lakes, they could devastate the native fish population.
We've got fish like lake trout and walleye and yellow perch that form the backbone of a $7 billion sport fishery. These fish are the kind that can get pushed out.
Right now, we're fighting the Asian carp on two main fronts. One in Ohio and one in Illinois. Remember those jumping carp? They've been found in the Mississippi River and its tributaries since the 1980s. Some of those tributaries in Illinois connect to the Great Lakes through shipping canals, and Asian carp could follow those canals into Lake Michigan and beyond. Since 2002, the only things standing in their way have been three electric barriers in Romeoville, Illinois, 37 miles from Lake Michigan. They're operated by the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers.
It would be very difficult for any fish to swim directly through the electrical fields when they're on and operating.
Chuck Shea is a project manager for the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers.
As a fish comes into the electrical field, it gets a stronger and stronger electrical shock, and most fish will turn around.
We do know that those barriers have done a pretty effective job at keeping them contained, but we also know that they're not perfect.
I don't know that we can say anything in life is absolutely 100% effective.
In fact, two Asian carp have been found on the other side of the barriers. A big head carp was caught in Lake Calumet in 2010. And in 2017, a silver carp was caught in Little Calumet River, just 9 miles from Lake Michigan. The Corps has proposed an additional barrier system 10 miles away at the Brandon Road Lock and Dam, near the front lines of the carp population. It would cost over $750 million. Former Illinois Governor Bruce Rauner balked at both the cost to taxpayers and the impact on shipping. But current Governor J.B. Pritzker approved engineering and design work in April, although he's concerned about costs too. The Corps of Engineers estimates the project would take until 2028 to complete. But Illinois hasn't been ignoring the carp. The state's Department of Natural Resources is well aware of the threat they pose.
Whenever any of these carps are out of balance, there's too many of them, they're going to have catastrophic ecological effects.
Instead of building barriers, Illinois has been fighting the Asian carp the old-fashioned way, by catching them. Since 2012, the Illinois DNR has paid commercial fishermen to catch thousands of silver and big head carp in rivers that connect to the Great Lakes.
All Asian carp all the time is our little mantra.
We use multiple gears, that is nets, to move fish through funnels into areas where we can capture them all at once. This is a big operation. It uses multiple federal and state agencies working together with contracted commercial fishermen.
The hope is that reducing the carp population here will keep them from moving toward the lakes. And it's been working. The Illinois DNR estimates that Asian carp populations closer to Lake Michigan have dropped by 96% since they began tracking numbers in 2012.
Over the past 5 years, they've removed 7 million pounds of Asian carp, which is a huge amount of fish. And we know that it is actually easing the pressure on the barriers in Chicago, so it's doing its job effectively. But those kinds of solutions, as effective as they're going to be, are only a part of it.
300 miles east on the Sandusky River, the Ohio Department of Natural Resources is mainly concerned with grass carp.
Unfortunately, through some method, grass carp have gotten out into the Sandusky River, the Maumee River, and Lake Erie. There are concerns over their impact on the ecosystem through consuming vegetation that's important for other species.
Ohio allows the use of sterile grass carp to control aquatic vegetation. Since the fish can't reproduce, there was no cause for concern until a troubling discovery in 2012.
When a commercial fisherman in the Sandusky River caught about a dozen very small, young grass carp, we had those tested and they came back as diploid fish, which means they could reproduce.
Grass carp aren't nearly as abundant as the silver and bighead carp in Illinois, and the Ohio DNR is trying to keep it that way.
I'm gonna turn around and go with the current.
This year, they'll operate an electrofishing boat all season long.
So an electrofishing boat has a generator on board and a control box. So it pumps electricity in the water. When a fish swims into that field, they just basically get stunned. The guys in the front of the boat can then net the fish and put them in the holding tank. Really within a few moments of getting out of the electric current and into the holding tank, the fish are typically A-OK. It does not kill anything.
Since 2012, the DNR and commercial fishermen have caught about 200 grass carp. And there's a reason they're focused here in Fremont.
This is kind of ground zero on the Sandusky River. It's a high flow, fast current. It's turbulent. This is where they like to spawn on the Sandusky.
While eliminating Asian carp is not off the table, experts like Andrew Reeves temper expectations.
What I think is a reasonable thing that we can hope for Asian carp, that they will become a part of the ecosystem rather than what we've seen in the Illinois or the Mississippi, where they are 70, 80, 90% of the biomass.
It's not something that's just going to go away. Of the fish that we've collected since 2012, about 75% have been diploid or capable of reproducing. So that's concerning to us, which is why we're ramping up efforts for grass carp removal and control.
Meanwhile, concern for the Great Lakes grows. On June 6th, the Great Lakes and St. Lawrence Cities Initiative, a collection of mayors and elected officials from over 130 cities in the region, issued a declaration demanding action to stop Asian carp. No more studies or delays.
With the Congress looking at appropriating, the governor now coming out as a sponsor, we don't need to continue studies. We need to get this project done.
Their declaration requests that the U.S. government and the Army Corps of Engineers complete the barriers at the Brandon Road Lock and Dam by 2022, 6 years earlier than the Corps of Engineers' estimated date of completion.
For more from Great Lakes Now, please like this video, subscribe to our channel, and follow us on social media.